Now, there's some good news, some bad news, and some even better news than this. Let me start with the bad news. The bad news is what you know, but you don't want to talk about. At some point, life will reduce you to little. You ever been there? Someday, life will reduce you to little. There will be a consuming fire. Maybe you're the arsonist that started it, or maybe it's in your neighbor's yard and it rolls over into your life. But there will be a fire that begins to consume you, and everything that is not of God will begin to burn away. Any minister that stands up and tells you that faith is an exemption from pain, do not listen to them. Faith does not exempt us from fire. The bad news is life is going to reduce you and humble you. The good news is you will be saved. You will escape it, even as if you're escaping from the flames. You can imagine your house is on fire, and Paul uses this imagery that you lose everything, but you escaped. What do we tell our kids? You know, I can get another car, but I can't get another kid. We will lose so much, and it may not have anything to do with material possessions, but Paul says you're going to escape it. So the bad news is life's going to hit you hard. The good news is you'll have a chance to be standing or go to heaven. There's your two choices. Or you can finally embrace the good, greater news. Even though life is going to remove everything that is not of God from you, you will get a chance to begin again and build on the foundation one more time.